Okie dokie, I've taken notes. This is 12 Canadian whiskies I think everybody should try. They're not super expensive. A couple of these are actually discount type whiskies and whatnot, but I think they're all worth the buy. This one's kind of hard to find. It's not around often, but every now and then it pops up. Danfield's limited edition 21-year-old whiskey. Now, it popped up twice in the liquor store here that I know of. The bottle that I had is actually I got it in Regina, but I saw this on the shelf a couple of times here. Which is kind of amazing because we don't get nothing. 40 Creek Confederation Oak Reserve. Now that's just yummy. 40 Creek Copper Pot. I do believe Quig likes that one kind of a lot. Gibson's Finest Rare 18-year-old. And now that's something Quig I'm sure doesn't like because it's rather sweet. All the Gibson's products except the Gibson's Dark is kind of sweet. So anyways, Gibson's Finest 12-year-old. You notice I didn't include the 8-year-old. Anyways, JP Weiser's Double Still. JP Weiser's 18-year-old, which is a considerable step up. Both of those are actually a considerable step up from just the normal JP Weiser's Deluxe. So, lot number 40, single copper pot. That's the lower of the lot 40 price range. There's another one out there that's kind of double that price, so which makes it slightly unaffordable to most people I know. Anyways, Crown Royal Black. Some people don't like this one either, but I thought it was really nice. It's got an extra 5% alcohol per volume, and it's I just enjoyed it. I never did a review on I think any of these. Maybe I have. I don't know. I can't search my own videos on my phone because it won't let you. You need to do it on the browser, and I'm not firing up the computer to find out. Anyways, Crown Royal Northern Harvest. This was International Whiskey of the Year a few years ago, and I don't know how that happened, but it is actually not that expensive, and it is quite yummy. And it's just both of the Black and the Northern Harvest are a considerable step up from the normal, just everyday run-of-the-mill Canadian or Crown Royal, that is. And the specialty flavored blends, I didn't like any of them. I really didn't. So now Alberta Premium, this is my go-to. This is the whiskey I get way more often than anything else. It's kind of simple. It's not very complicated, but it's still quite flavorful in its own way, and it doesn't have a huge bite of rye. That rye bite, it doesn't have a huge kick of that, so it's smoother than a lot of discount ryes. There's a bug crawling on me. How are there bugs this time of year? Oh yes, it's above freezing. Anyways, global warming's not real. Anyways, Alberta Premium is my go-to because it's quite inexpensive, and it's nice for the price. Alberta Premium Dark Horse, which is more money than the Alberta Premium, but it's quite a lot more complicated tasting as well and whatnot. And some people actually actively dislike this because it has the taste of black currants. And I've noticed a lot of people just go, meh, when they taste black currants. So they don't like them and whatnot. But I liked it. I liked it a fair bit. So, yeah. Honorable mention goes to something my dad used to buy, and it was horrible back in the 70s. It was called Five Star, and it was atrocious. It was one of the worst things I'd ever tasted in my life. And then it came back, and it wasn't terrible. It was there. Now, it's about the same price. It's literally within a dollar of Alberta Premium, and the Alberta Premium is just a lot better. But yeah, the Five Star, it's just not what it used to be by far. It's actually worth the money now. So yeah, anyways, that's it. That's all. You have a fabtacular day and keep smiling.